like an angel. He had this kind of white skin that you could see through.
This powerful young body. And then there would be these hands. Incredible fingernails.
Those beautiful, long, thin fingers.
He'd take the guitar and start to play, and every single note was crystal clear and strong and rang.
The tragic story of this young musician who died on the brink of fame has inspired many. Artists such as Kate Bush, R.E.M., and Everything But the Girl have cited him as a great influence, ensuring that his music has been brought to a new generation, and blurdy blurdy blur, whatever I was going to say, his memory will live on.
So it's a very tragic story, Nick Drake's story. Would you have a message for his family, his friends? Do you think the tragedy of his death is leaning people more towards his music? Excuse me. Can I have a quick word with you now?
Only like 2 years ago, and I've never heard anything quite so inspiring.
I knew this guy had died 24 years ago, but I didn't realise exactly how timeless the recordings were done.
And it must be so frustrating to be that good and to have no recognition.
Some people thought he was actually playing here tonight.
Yeah.
He died 24 years ago.
But I don't think I got the impression that there wasn't the major interest in his work until there was a time lag.
There was, yes.
Well, we first met them just after we were married in 1956. We were invited to the Motor Show Ball in London, and we were asked to meet a Mr. and Mrs. Drake. So Mr. and Mrs. Drake met Mr. and Mrs. Drake.
Scared off by him.
Also, we get phone calls asking if we are Rodney and Molly or if we are Nick's parents. And we have to say, no, we're not.
We've been amazed at the number of young people who have come to Tanworth and really treated it as a sort of shrine almost.
It's a cult that is growing, I'm sure.
It's a lovely door.
I wonder how much it cost.
For the door?
No, the house.
£300,000.
It's pathetic that this recognition, which he was lamenting wasn't there in his lifetime, is actually now coming.
Right.
I think as far as the village is concerned, it's probably his sister who is better known. Because she's been seen more and heard more in the village, particularly through the medium of television.
Cliff Rochester, please contact the stage door. Cliff Rochester, please contact the stage door.
There's nothing anonymous about Nick, ever. And I remember him coming once to BBC rehearsal rooms, and he sort of sat at the table with me in the cast, and sort of a lowering presence. And gradually everyone left, because they didn't know what to say quite.
Call, please, Miss Drake, Miss Emery, Miss Jay, and Mr. Town.
I suppose in many ways he took more after my mother and I took after my father. I always thought of myself as a black sheep of the family because I never composed anything at all. My musical activities seemed to be in full swing already. There was a film show on Saturday, and nobody seemed to be prepared to provide music before it. So I formed a small group, and after one practice we went on and attempted to play. In one number I completely forgot the words of the last verse, and we ground to an embarrassing halt in the middle of the song. However, the most amazing thing was that quite a large number of people congratulated us afterwards and said that they had thoroughly enjoyed it. The fact that 90% of all Morburians are musical ignoramai is certainly very helpful at times.
I think you have to remember that these public schools, they may be institutions with a sort of wall around them in effect, but actually they're microcosms of society at large. What's great about a public school is that if you have an interest, as we did, groups are formed around it very, very quickly. So you had the jazz society, you had cigarettes, you had literary things. Everything formed groups. These all interlocked too.
Now, this, actually, I remember. I remember you doing these.
Oh, this was at Aix, well, you know. But actually,
it looks a bit like the guy in Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah, but I tell you what's good. Yeah. He did wear funny shoes like that.
And actually, the fingers are right, because actually he did have this.
It's terrible. Yep. Look, come on.
No, anatomically.
I'm trying to sell paintings. I don't want anybody to...
Yes.
Those here, I'm looking around for an opportunity to start playing my guitar in public. There have, in fact, been one or two chances already, but I've been rather lazy about it. I went to a jazz club in Aix the other night and stood in for about half an hour with some other students. I mostly played piano, but also had a go on an alto.
It was one of those afternoons in the south of France after lunch, everybody very relaxed, and I played my guitar, and Nick Drake very quietly in the corner listened and applauded, and then somebody asked him to play, and that was an extremely moving experience. And he played some Billie Holiday and some blues. I'd never met anybody of my age who could do anything that well. Just magically get these sounds that are, you know, so strong, flying across the fretboard.
You can say the sun is shining.
Lovely stuff.
When do I can see the moon and it seems so clear? You can take a road that takes you to the stars. Now I can take a road that'll see me through. I can take a road that'll see me through.
I knew that Nick played the guitar and he played other people's songs, but it was when he came back from Aix that he played songs that he'd composed himself.
Are we allowed to mention all the dope smoking that went on? Because, I mean, that was a huge part of it, wasn't it?
Was it was a huge part of it. We have to say that.
You know, an afternoon would sort of just go by without one really realising, or an evening, or a whole night, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sort of in a stoned...
Yeah, stoned haze, but always music, always...
No drink.
No drink.
Hardly.
Drugs started in Aix, certainly, without any question.
There was I'd say there was a kind of, as Aix went on, there was a sort of split in a way. I think there was definitely a kind of a drugs crowd who sort of graduated
and
into North Africa.
And Nick began to run with those.